Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Randall's Monday. We're going to keep going from where we left off, and the only thing I can think of that went wrong was our scarecrow didn't really do the job that I wanted it to do. So, there's only one other thing I can think of. And that is, well, we got the visual factor down. It looks like a scarecrow. So, maybe it needs to smell like a human, I guess, or something smell bad.
Yeah, now you almost stink as much as some of the people in here. Maybe even a little more. Yeah, maybe not. I think it's just a different kind of smell.
Yeah, the problem here is... what the hell? I don't remember the cat doing that. I guess we're just gonna watch the cat.
Oh, now I get it. I'm not about to die. The cat was just following the stench of the dead rat coming off the sponge. I don't need you in my inventory anymore. See ya.
Right. So, that's one problem. I think I might have to do what I said last time. But before I do, let me pick that up. I think I'm gonna have to go back, get more nicotine gum, and redo that whole conversation with Sleazy here. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to do that. The reasoning? Because I didn't put the sponge on the scarecrow the first time, and we have to do all this again because reasons, that's why. Not my favorite aspect of the game, but I can kind of see it. You're doing the whole day over because you screwed up the puzzle the first time. I would have imagined that they wouldn't have let you done it that badly, but apparently they do, as a little bit of a screw you.
How can you smoke that filth? Your lungs must look like coal.
Maybe, but...
you should try nicotine gum. It's way healthier.
I'd like that, but you know nicotine gum's the only thing I can't get in.
Don't worry, I'll take care of that. And I only want a cigarette and a match in exchange.
I guess.
Thanks. Here's your gum. Don't worry, I'll make sure the gum is always flowing for you.
Well, that was a lot easier, a lot faster than I imagined it would have been. So, you know, at least there's that. I think you already had a cigarette, but yeah, I guess now you got two. Don't you? Yeah, you got at least, I think you had two, but for some reason it's showing three. Doesn't really matter right now, because all you need to do is light this match up, and I think we'll be able to be on our way again. Get rid of those things, and then I can attach the hose.
I'm like having to waste my phosphorus on this, but I guess I'll just have to find a way to get more.
Oh, believe me, if you need more, you will find more. It's not like it hasn't happened before, so attach this thing and we're good to go. Well, I gotta use it, but I mean, okay, I gotta turn the thing first. I still say this is not exactly a working hose, considering there's like no water coming out. I think the whole point of this is you have to like turn the handle or turn the thing, but... it doesn't look like it's functional. And now this should go, and then the crow should not get my clover again.
Okay, old pal. Let's hope it works this time.
This should work, I think. I was a little confused, like, why did the scarecrow not scare the crow? Damn it! I think that's why.
Okay, today is the day. Let's go to the field.
I guess they don't have, like, cell inspections, otherwise he would have been found out long ago. Wait, pick up the nicotine gum. You never know when you might need more. I don't think I will, but I might. In case this doesn't work. I think it worked, though. I mean, there's nothing else that I can even think of.
I did it! I managed to grow something and the crow didn't eat it. Wow! I haven't felt this good since I bought the Godfather box set and it didn't include the third one. This is great!
Okay, it's safe to say you passed the test. Congratulations. From now on, you'll be this prison's guardian. Here's the key as promised.
Thanks, Murray. Your kind words flatter me. Hey, could I also be in charge of the woman's wing?
You better take this seriously, kid. That key brings great responsibility. Don't forget it.
I'll make you proud, Murray.
Yeah. So at least I got fertilizer now, I suppose. So that's another instrument in what we need to escape. So that is at least something.
I have no reason.
I think I know what you're trying to say, Randall, but you come across, and I don't use this word very lightly, you come across as a retard. All right, use the key on the padlock, damn.
I knew it. That horrible stench could only mean one thing. Fertilizer.
And no, I don't particularly care about being politically correct, because that was pretty stupid. Well, there's a locked chest there. Well, use the key on the chest. I can't do that. You tell me you wouldn't think someone's a little off if they said that? Come on. Be honest. I'm not advocating making fun of people, for the record. I'm just saying. You'd probably go, maybe they're not all there. I'm getting a little sidetracked here, and that's probably not good, because some people get really pissy when you talk about that subject. So let's move on to something else. Now I need the pink, I want to say Pepto-Bismol, but, if I get a copyright strike, I guess we'll know why. We need that pink bismuth, or whatever it's called. So I guess I should go talk to that dude and see what he wants to trade for it. Because hopefully he'll have something he wants to trade for, because I don't think I can steal it. I could try.
Hey, how come you're not eating?
What's it to you, rookie? Get lost.
I was just worried about your nutritional needs.
Go bother someone else. Not in the mood.
What's the deal with that pink bottle?
What about it?
No, nothing. I'm just curious. What the hell is it? Because it doesn't look like a strawberry milkshake.
It's an antacid, rookie. You happy? Now fuck off.
No, I meant the composition. Why don't you check on the label?
No.
Okay, I'll do it then. May I?
No freaking way.
Come on, man. It would really be helping me out.
Hey, you're just a fucking newbie. What part of fuck off don't you understand?
I'll be back. Do you by chance have any cooking oil or fertilizer?
Are you fucking kidding me?
No.
What can I say? No, I don't have any. Now fuck off.
You good for nothing.
And watch your tongue, rookie, or you might lose it.
My tongue?
Among other things.
I better...
Yeah, you better.
Oh, Mr. Hardass, sitting on his ass, is gonna threaten me. Oh yeah, no, that's a good idea. I mean, it's not like I have a crowbar or a rake or anything I could bash your skull in. No, keep acting like a hardass. We'll see what happens.
I don't want to start a fight.
Really? The guy's being a dickhead and you don't want to start a fight? You're not going to last very long in prison, Randall. I mean, people are going to call you a punk, is what they're going to call you. Anyway, steal it. That'll prove your alpha supremacy. Do it.
Don't even think about it.
Okay.
You're not eating. You don't need an antacid. Unless you're going to claim that, well, I might need it for later. Well, maybe, but still. Stop being a pussy prisoner having lunch, even though you're not eating, so it's a lying prisoner as well. I need it. I don't know how the hell to get that now. Well, that was a dry well. Do I even need anything with... Have I even done anything with Mortimer in the prison? It seems like I should have done something with Mortimer's character here. Talked to him or done something.
No time for growling.
Wait, does he even want the pillows?
That's Mortimer's pillowcase.
Well, he does have a pillowcase. The only thing I could possibly use to possibly get it would be like the rake. Though I don't think he's gonna let me do this. As soon as I can... Damn it! Don't block the way, you idiot! Come on, there we go. There we go. Hey, it actually worked.
Got it. Didn't think I'd manage without my dear old trusty duck hanger.
I still have no clue what in the hell that's for, but at least I have something from Mortimer's cell now, so I guess I feel better. Like, less I miss something like that. So I still need cooking oil, which one would assume would be in the kitchen.
Good morning, Bruno. What's for lunch today? Something yummy, I hope.
But who do you think you are to just burst into my kitchen like that?
What do you mean? I was...
I don't want to see your dog ugly mug in my kitchen again. You hear me?
Hey, relax. I just thought I'd...
Get out of here! Don't make me say it twice.
Okay.
Well, that's not... I'm not going to be getting kitchen oil or cooking oil from in the kitchen, so what in the hell do I do now? I cannot imagine anything worthwhile is in the frickin' library, and I'm always freaked out by Brooks here and his thousand-yard stare. He's seen some shit. Probably seen more than a few people shanked in the ear. And I don't mean that in a sexual manner. I mean a literal shank into the ear, probably through the brain. That would make you have a thousand-yard stare, too, if you saw it enough. That's why you couldn't pay me enough to be in to work as a guard in a prison. Oh, no. They hate you. You're a guard. And you could kill somebody as a guard accidentally just by talking to an inmate. Oh, yeah. You think they won't talk to... You think they won't kill snitches? Yeah, well, we're getting off topic here. I guess not really. We are in a prison in-game, so I guess that's not technically off topic, but it's not really relevant to the gameplay at hand. How the hell am I going to do this? Does he like cigarettes? Give them to him.
You know, I might need them later.
Okay. To be fair, I thought maybe that might work. I doubt he wants a magazine, but I could try it.
I'm sure he won't find it interesting.
I doubt he wants this.
I'd rather keep it.
Well, you could try giving this.
I'd rather not do that.
I'm just saying, I mean, he's not being very cooperative. You might as well try and poison him, right? I don't think that's the way that world works, no.
He doesn't seem willing to cooperate.
And that's why I told you to use the crowbar. He'd be cooperating then. He'd be face down in a pool of his own blood, and you can take what you want. This is prison, man. This isn't Mr. Rogers' neighborhood. You gotta do what you gotta do to get the job done.
Much better now.
Honestly, I was just trying to get them to group together into one square. Three-piece rope. What the hell do I need a rope for? I suppose to climb down from a thing in the escape, but it's not really relevant now. Yeah, I didn't think so. Maybe they could use it as like a hook? Grappling hook? I didn't think so. I don't think crowbars are meant to be used like that. Did you not pick it? I didn't pick up anything in the... No, that's not annoying at all, even though it was pretty much my own fault. No, it's not annoying at all. I just kind of walked off from it.
Okay, I got the fertilizer, and I know exactly where to find it. I just need a little patience.
Which I think means you gotta wait until the next day. Yeah. Oh, so he's gonna do it multiple times. Hey, it works. Day 2189, Randall's Redemption.
Like I said, in prison, a man will do most anything to keep his mind occupied. It turns out Randy's favorite hobby was to amass cigarettes and matches, one at a time. Day by day. I guess after all he'd been through, Randy decided he'd been here just about long enough.
Okay, prisoners, listen up. As you already know, yesterday we welcomed Mr. Randall Hicks to our penitentiary. Nobody knows if he's some kind of tobacco industry mogul or just a guy with a lot of resources. But the thing is that he has several items in his cell that are pretty coveted around here. He's been given some privileges because of his status, so don't forget it. And treat him with respect, okay?
Thanks for the lecture, Mr. Turnkey. But I reckon the fact we're all standing here keeping watch on Mr. Hicks's cell shows that we already know he's a man who takes care of his friends.
Well, that happened quickly.
Well. Today's the day. I feel it. Been locked up in here long enough. You know, I'm feeling a little sad about leaving this place, though. Grown kinda fond of this filthy little hellhole. Anyway, time to get some work done. Let's check what we have so far. Soap? Check. Phosphorus? I think 400 pounds of matches are more than enough. Cooking oil? Negative. Pink bismuth? No. And fertilizer. Got it already. Well, I guess I need to find a way to get the rest of the stuff. Can't be that hard.
You've been in there for almost 6 years. I'd probably be in a hurry to get out. Higgs.
Morning, Steve. Any news?
Your new shipment of gum and cigarettes just arrived.
Perfect. Tell the guys to store it in warehouse number 4.
But, sir, there's no more room in that warehouse.
Well, then work something out.
Yes, Mr. Higgs.
I means that he's king of the... Oh, my God. This dude's here now. Alan.
That guy shouldn't be here. He should just stay in the damn nut house.
Yeah, well, with the government shutdown of mental hospitals in the last 20 years, they're put in prison. It's a great system we got here in the U.S. It's not at all.
Well, well, well. Look who's here.
Excuse me? Do I know you?
Of course you do, old friend. I don't think you remember me, though. It's been a long time.
So, did you want something? Look, right now I'm a little busy. I'm getting ready for tomorrow's contest.
I always want something, Alan. I always do.
I see you know my name. Are you gonna tell me who you are?
The name's Higgs. I'm the owner of this hellhole.
Oh, that's right. I've heard a lot about you.
I don't even know where to start with this.
How the hell did you end up in here?
Nah, it's all a big conspiracy.
Oh, really? By whom?
Everybody! Government agencies, secret organizations, security forces, they were all in it together!
But why? You're just a loon in a tutu.
That's what someone with a mind as weak as yours would think! Anyway, I have no time to explain it all. So, long story short, I killed a reptilian, and I got caught. I'm just lucky I'm still alive. You don't even know what a reptilian is, do you?
Of course I do. They secretly run the world, right? The ones that used to eat mice on TV?
Well, kinda.
Okay, and what did this reptilian look like?
He was kinda fat, and he always wore the same filthy wife-beater vest. He used to go around pushing this cart and selling balloons. I hate balloons. Hate them.
You killed that guy? Oh, come on, man. That guy had suffered enough already with that helium poisoning thing.
Don't feel sorry for him. I never got to see his reptilian form, but he was clearly one of them. He had a very high-pitched voice. Too high. I'd say I had to rip him open. The guy squealed like a pig.
But the high-pitched voice thing was because of the helium. Don't you know what happens if you inhale it?
Nope, and I couldn't care less. He had it coming.
And I just helped him on his way, okay?
Okay, okay. God, you're quite the vigilante, Alan. So, how come you don't go around yelling your name anymore?
Oh, I've never done such a thing.
Are you sure? What about your other self?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sure you do, Robert, you sick maniac.
My name's not Robert. And honestly, if I had a split personality, don't you think I would know about it?
Yeah, right. Then why did they lock you up in the psych wing?
Because this is all just one big fat conspiracy, okay? People who know the real truth like me are a thorn in the side of those in the higher circles. But I'm telling you, I don't have a split personality. And I just don't go around yelling my name, okay?
Oh, of course not. I mean, that would be crazy. Anyway, I have to go.
Okay, but watch out for those guys. There's bound to be a couple about who've managed to infiltrate this place.
Sure. I'll be careful.
So, in a nutshell, he killed the balloon salesman because he didn't like his voice. And he hates balloons. Yeah, that... I'm not sure if that's more crazy or more psychopathic. I think they're arguably the same. And yes, I'm going to attempt to just walk my ass down into the kitchen again. Probably get balled out again. Or not. Can you please take the damned oil? No, he'll never take the oil. He has to look at everything else. Why don't you ever take the oil? Stick your hand in there, it'd be funny. I did not actually expect you to do that. What the hell is this?
A pressure cooker.
Well, I kind of figured... Actually, no, I didn't. I was going to say, I kind of figured that, but no, I thought that was just a pan. Like, not a pan, but like a... I don't know what you call that thing. You put soup in it on the stovetop. I didn't think that was a pressure cooker. Who the hell puts a pressure cooker on the... What the... Grill? Not a grill. What is that? Is that a stove? I don't think that's an oven. I don't think you do that. I mean, I guess you could, and it's an oven. It's not like there's a heat coming... I guess there is probably heat coming off that. But anyway, I've never seen anybody do that. So that surprised me a little bit. Is there anything else in here? I'm not messing around with the hot plate again.
I can't just pick it up with my bare hands.
Okay, so use the magazine.
I don't think this is going to make the soup taste any better.
I was telling you to pick it up with that. Numbnuts. Use the newspaper. Pick that. No, not the hot plate. Okay, so I need to find... What the hell would make soup taste better? Put this stuff in. I'm sure that'll feel good. Or taste good.
I don't think...
We're not here to actually make it taste better, Randall. We're here to poison as many people as possible. That's what we're... As a big final middle finger to the rest of the people still living here. That's what we're doing. Is there anything in there?
Who knows what's in...
Well, can you at least open this thing?
I need a key to open it.
Some bitch. Okay, so you need a key. Where in the hell am I going to get a key? Seemingly not in here, because there's nothing in here besides... I can't even look at that thing. And Oh, that's just that. I don't need that. I guess it'd been too easy if this was the cooking oil, this stuff. But I have a feeling it's in the pantry, but I don't have a key. I don't even know who that... Wait. Bruno would have the key. He's in the kitchen, right? So we gotta go back into his cell, which I think is shared by Alan now. And then...
Nah.
Telling you to look in there, not necessarily get up there. What's that? That is nothing. That is a drain for blood if someone shanks someone. That's what that is. At least I think it is. Yeah, just use his toilet. He won't mind.
I don't think so.
Wait, no, he was in this room. He wasn't in Alan's. What the hell am I thinking? Maybe he knows something.
Hey, how you doing, Carl?
Really good, Mr. Hicks. Trying to enjoy the fact that thanks to this penitentiary institution, I can spend another day laying around and doing nothing.
You really know how to live it up, Carl.
Thanks for the compliment, Mr. Hicks. I appreciate it.
All right, enjoy your rest.
I will.
That didn't help at all. Can you look up there?
Nah, I don't need it.
Okay, there's nothing in the sink, so I need a key to the pantry, but I don't have a clue as to where to even find such a thing. Wow, this prison chapter is, I think, longer than any other chapter in the entire game, or so at least feels like. But yeah, that's gonna be it for today. I didn't get a whole hell of a lot done, to be quite honest, but that's what we're gonna be doing for today. So thank you for watching, and I'm going to be, trying to think of, use my old noodle a little bit while this is encoding, getting ready to record the next session. And we'll see, hopefully the next time will go a bit better. So thank you for watching, and hopefully I shall see you. Farewell until then.